Wait for the signal Rose and I will give. Okay, then.
So how are you, Cassandra? How is Rosa doing?
Your arrival is about 2 days late, you know. That was the last time I talked to Rosa. You could have talked to her then.
So it's the two of you who pay those goons who are after us?
Well, why don't you just ask Rosa? And pray that she will tell you everything. Because if you're just planning to ask me, it will take one big miracle to ever make me talk. Goodbye, Maningning. I won't waste my time talking to you.
Maningning, why did you take her phone?
Eric, if Cassandra and Rosa have been talking, then she'll call this number again.
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Harry. Harry Medina.
Oh, Medina.
Were you his cellmate before when he was still in prison?
What's the problem with Medina?
Well, nothing really. It's just that since he got out of prison, I haven't heard from him.
Maybe he's dead.
That's what I was thinking of. But when you were together, did he mention a place where he might stay when he finally goes out of prison?
Is he your boyfriend?
Oh, no.
That was a long time ago, miss.
Oh, Melissa. Yes, Melissa.
Miss Melissa, there's already been so many things that's happened here. And I have talked to a number of other inmates, so it's sort of hard for me to remember the things Harry has mentioned. But then hold on. I remember that there was this one time. He said that the day was special for him. I think he said it was the birthday of his kid. Oh yes, Harry didn't do anything the whole day. He was just thinking about seeing that kid of his.
Harry has a child?
I've been thinking about what you said, Cassandra.
You dared me go back home to that country. I shall return.
But I will not inform you about my plans anymore, because I know that you will tell all my children, and you'll intend to harm them too.
Maningning owes me a great deal, so she will have to answer to me.
She will suffer. She will die like her sister.
Do we have an understanding, Cassandra?
Hello, Cassandra?
You're just evil to the core, Rosa.
Why, what did she say?
I didn't know that there was a thief in our family. Give me back my mobile phone.
Maningning! Maningning!
And to think that you and I have the same blood. But I know that you are nothing but a traitor.
Oh, that Rosa. I knew it, she can't be trusted. And so what? What if Rosa and I have been talking? And what if we've been planning your death already? You don't have any evidence against me. If I were you, sister, I'd just be careful.
Hey, stop it. That's enough. Come on, Meningning. Come on.
You big fat trap!
Harry has a child?
Hmm.
A son or a daughter?
He didn't really say anything else. But then wait. I thought you were his good friend. How come you didn't know that?
What? Oh no. We just, lost touch during the time he was in jail. So, does he have a wife?
A wife? No, I don't think that he was ever married. But I'm sure he had a child. I even remember asking him about it. About how that could happen. But he just smiled at me and that was it. I remember that his being a father was very sudden. Having a kid was unexpected.
So, what brings you here?
I was just going to ask about our plans with Sigmund. It's been a long time since you last said anything to us. Are we still on with getting back at that guy?
Why? Are you afraid of meeting Bukol again?
No, it's not like that.
Don't even deny it. I know what it is you're afraid of, okay? So listen here. We have a new ace, but I'm still laying down the plans. But as soon as I'm done, you'll be the first to know.
Who is it? Is it Meningning?
It's Cassandra. Right now, I know you can't keep yourself from telling Meningning. But the moment Sigmund finds out about this, you know what will happen to your family.
So what about now, Sandy? Based on what you've seen, I'm hoping that you won't call off your wedding to Armand, right?
Cheetah, will you just keep your mouth shut? You should be careful. Someone might hear you.
Oh, wow, Sandy. You're the one who should stop. Just be careful with spying on Habagat. Someone else might see you, right? Okay. Are you sure? Sandy, just accept what you have. You know you have Armand anyway. So now Habagat has Angel. I'm the only one who doesn't have a partner. This is the perfect time for you to forget about Habagat. You should move on now. So, are you okay? Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Yes, I do.
So since you look like you want to put your life in order, maybe it's time you reconciled with your sister too.
I think it's possible for me to forget that I'm in love with Habagat. But for me, to forget all the evil that Elena has done? I don't think I can do that. Come on.
Hold on. Meningning, wait. Meningning.
You should listen to your boyfriend. Or else, I might file a case against you for assaulting me.
Tell me, why do you hate me so much? What have I ever done to make you hate me so much?
What's your crime? Your only crime is to be born of our good-for-nothing father. Because instead of giving me all of the attention and the love he should have, he gives it all to you. And yes, I have lived in this mansion, but it's like I'm not here. Because when you're here, grandmother and father's attention are always on you. And you know, there's only one way for me to get their attention. And that's to get rid of you.
And you're blaming me for that. Why won't you blame yourself instead, Cassandra? From the moment that you came into this house, you've acted differently. And you've set me up for our sister's death. When you knew perfectly well that it was Rosa who killed her, you allowed Rosa to use you, Cassandra. And that's the reason why you've never been able to get the love you've been craving for from our father. And what did you get out of it? You even lost Victor, the only person who really loved you. And it's all because of your own foolishness.
How dare you say that?
Hey, come on. Come on, will you stop? Your anger at each other will never amount to anything good, so stop it. Manining, that's enough.
Cassandra.
Come on, Manining.
And what is the big problem here?
And now do you see what I'm saying?
Cassandra.
But you've known Harry for a long time, right? Even before you and Joel moved to this place, am I right? Don't you know of any woman that could have borne Harry's child?
Well, I only know that Rose is the only girlfriend he's had. But then, Rose already has a child before there were even a couple, and that's Eric. So I'm sure that Eric is not Harry's kid.
Well, that's exactly what I was thinking. But fine, let's say that Harry did have a kid somehow. What does that have to do with him getting even with Sigmund, and with you and Maningning?
I really can't think of anything else except for... if Harry did have a kid, and he went to jail because of Sigmund, maybe something happened to his kid, maybe his life was screwed. Of course, it was all Sigmund's fault why he was sent to prison. So what else can he do but seek revenge later on with Sigmund's own child? And that's Maningning, right?
Hang on. Does Harry know that Maningning confessed to you already? That he was the one who ordered her to steal from Sigmund?
I don't really know, but it sure looks that way. Because Maningning has refused to accept any help coming from Harry.
I think that you still have a chance to find out the whole truth from Harry. He still considers you one of his good friends, right? Then why don't you hang out with him again? Imagine how a colored cloth can mess up the whites when it touches, right? You know, it's no different. If you'll keep hanging around with him, he will eventually reveal his secrets to you. Just make sure that you'll hang out with him more often.
Cassandra, why can't you and Maningning just get along? You two are sisters. Isn't the blood flowing in your veins enough to make you treat each other with even a small degree of civility?
Are you blaming me again for what happened, Father? Why would I be surprised? I'm the one who's always at fault. I still have something to attend to. Let's just talk later.
Cassandra, I'm not done with you yet.
What else is there for us to talk about, Father?
Cassandra, I've tried to be patient with you. You might even be responsible for what happened to Eleanor. Even your connivance with Rosa, who might be your sister's murderer. I've set aside all of that.
Well, I think you did the right thing, Father. They only have all these theories against me anyway.
Well, what about me seeing you outside talking to my mortal enemy, Harry? Is that still a theory?
I'm not going to deny a thing, Father. You're right, Harry and I were talking outside. But before you start thinking of anything, will you please listen to me first? Harry was trying to get me over to side with him in his desire to get even with you. I love you, Father. And I don't want you to get hurt. That's why I declined. You should thank me, Father. Because even though I don't mean a thing to you, my love for you still reigned over me. Any more questions? I have to go now.
Here's my payment for Cheetah. Please give it to him. That's for the ice I got yesterday.
I will.
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
Oh! Oh, Sandy. I'm sorry. Sorry, Sandy.
Habagat.
So, how are you and Armand?
Well, we're okay. How about you and Angel? I heard that you're getting comfortable with each other.
Oh, yes, that's true. I'm really lucky to have her. I thought at first she will never accept me.
Well, why not?
Because, well, maybe nothing's wrong. It's okay. Nothing's wrong. Nothing's wrong if you find out now. Because before we were together, and then I rejected her because I was in love with you. So you see where
Honey,
I'm coming from.
I miss you. Oh, Sandy, you can tell me if my boyfriend's bothering you again.
Oh, not at all. We were just talking a little.
Congratulations again to you and Armand. What now, honey? Let's go before we get in late for the movie.
I forgot. Okay, Sandy. Well, go ahead, okay?
Let's go. Bye.
Honey. All right, what a flirt.
What's that you're saying?
Nothing.
Really nothing? I heard you say something. Hubby or a flirt? Who are you calling a flirt? Hey!
Harry?
Oh. Virgie, isn't it late? What's up?
Hi.
Armand!
It looks like you miss me a lot, right?
Armand, why don't we get married?
That's right, we are getting married. I've proposed to you already, right?
No. Let's get married as soon as possible, okay?
One of my bettors won. It's to sing. With a 24, she bet on 20. And won 18,000.
Well, that's great. You can treat us so bad.
Oh, but of course, yes. Harry? You know, I found out something about you.
Well, what is it?
That you have a child?
Here, have a drink.
You check first if it's okay.
You sure you're okay?
So, who are you fighting this time? You look like you're planning to hide out in my house again.
That's not exactly why I came over, Myrna. It's Maningning.
What is it?
Why?
I've searched all over the pier only to find you here, Maningning. Myrna, can I get a glass of water?
You're ordering me around? Get him a glass of water.
Give it to him.
Here.
Thank you.
You know, you're very spoiled. Okay, there. Now you've drank it all. What do you want to say to Maningning?
Maningning, I talked to Sir Harry. He says that the war with Sigmund is still on. And this time around, he said that he partnered up with your sister Cassandra.
Well, it looks like you've made a sudden decision, Sandy. Is there a problem? Tell me why you're in a hurry.
I'm not, Armand. It's just that I can't wait to be your wife any longer.
Okay. Then don't worry. First thing tomorrow, I'm going to talk to Father Simon about our wedding. Is that okay?
Hey, wait a minute.
Hey, Armand, I didn't know you were here.
Cheetah.
Is it okay for me to go inside my very own house?
Oh, okay. Just step
thanks
right
a
in.
Lot.
Come on.
So what brings you here?
Oh, because... Cheetah, do you have any idea why Sandy is suddenly in a rush to get married?
What? Well, how should I know? Maybe there was something in the air. A stench. Armand... Oh, don't mind her.
Hang on. If Harry is already working with Cassandra, then maybe he would be able to know and monitor Cassandra's plans against you, Maningning.
I think Bukal's right. So, what else did Harry talk to you about? Well, Octopus? Do you know how long he'll be working with that witch, Cassandra?
Well, as far as I can tell, it's recent. But Sir Harry is very secretive. For all we know, they've joined forces for some time now.
Octopus, you do know how cruel Harry can be, right? I'm very sure that he warned you not to tell anyone about this.
But Maningning, it's much better for you to know the truth. Don't worry about me. I can take care and protect myself.
But can you protect your own family? I'll go and see Harry now. I will try to find out what his motives are for partnering with Cassandra.
Maningning, you don't have to do that.
If it's necessary, then I will talk to him to keep him from hurting you and your own family, but you'll have to come with me to his hideout.
Thanks a lot.
I'm the one who should be thanking you.
And from where did you get that news?
I got it from one of my betters. He said he knew one of your former cellmates when you were in prison. He was saying that you have a kid. Is that the reason why you're taking revenge on Sigmund?
And who's this better? And who's this inmate in prison that you're talking about?
I don't think that's important. All I'm asking is that true?
Virgie, I don't have a child. Maybe they were talking about a different Harry, right? Besides, whether I had one or not, that's not the reason I want to get even with Sigmund. Because he's a traitor.
Hello?
Charles?
Mother.
I miss you very, very much, baby boy.
I want to see you again.
I would like us to see each other again. I'm very sorry for what I did, but...
What I did was a mistake.
Even up to now. Can't you still find it in your heart to forgive me?
Mother, you killed my wife.
I know that, but I really didn't want that.
I do regret it, Charles.
Please, my son. Please forgive me as your mother.
What you did isn't that easy to forgive.
I will wait, even if it takes forever.
I think I'm coming home very soon, Charles. I feel it. Very, very soon.
I love you. Very, very much. Baby boy. Baby boy.
Baby boy?
Well, don't you love me too? Baby boy?
So quick to tell on me, right, Octopus? But I've got to hand it to you. You weren't even scared of my threats. But never mind that. Or even now. You don't owe me anything anymore. Besides, all I wanted was for you to lead Maningning straight to me. Or maybe you would like to change your mind now. You can just say it. Very well. You can go now. Are you here because Cassandra and I are plotting something against Sigmund? Well, what is it to you if Cassandra's helping me out on this?
In that case, then you're also Cassandra and Rose's accomplice in their attempts to end our lives.
You know, Meningning, I didn't have anything to do with that at all. And my alliance with Cassandra is only against Sigmund, that's it. Didn't you turn me down on that? So now, if Sigmund ever finds out about Cassandra's connection with me, well then, maybe you're right about your suspicion against my connection to Cassandra. Will end up to be your family's enemy. But of course, I wouldn't want that to happen. You and your mother are dear to me. So guess what? I'll promise you this. I won't let your family get hurt. Just don't interfere with my plans. Go on now. I still have a lot to do.
I was just bragging a little.
What? Yes, right.
Well, it's
and
okay.
You, maybe you're still in love with Sandy, right?
Of course not. You're the one I love.
Oh, really? 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 Mm. Really?
Oh, yes. Just stop nagging me.
I don't want that. Mm. Well, and you? Do you want me
and
to
you,
do this?
Do you want me to do that? Huh?
No, I don't.
What would you like?
And you?
What are you doing?
I noticed you've been very affectionate these past few days.
Can you really blame me? I love you so much.
Oh.
Are you okay? Are you okay?
Oh, of course. You?
Mother, I thought you quit drinking already, so why did you come home very drunk last night?
Oh, no. I just had a few drinks with Harry. And it's all because I want him to start trusting me again. I really want him to treat me like a close friend. Because he's keeping a lot of secrets from us, and I want to know about so many things. And I was right. I did find out something. That Harry has a kid. And I really feel that this is one of the many reasons why he just hates your father so much. Meningning, I just had to do all of this because it's for our family, because I've already had it. I just can't figure out why he just won't leave our family alone. I really don't know what his motives are.
Mother, I'm very sorry, okay? I'm not really mad at you, but I was really surprised. But you know what, Mother? I really think that you're right. And I think that you should try to get close with Harry again, especially now that he's working with Cassandra against my father.
What? Just look at that. I can't believe how evil he is. And he's working together with Cassandra? What could they be planning against Sigmund now? Your father will have to know about this.
Mother, we shouldn't tell him now. I think that it would still be useless, even if I confront Cassandra, so... Besides, Harry warned me about telling Father. He specifically told me that Father shouldn't know about it.
So what? What are you planning now?
Exactly what have you been doing, Mother? I'll gather evidence I can use against them.
Meningning, Mother.
Yes.
This is my girlfriend. She's Angel.
Hi.
Well, what's this supposed to mean, Habagat? You don't love Sandy anymore?
Mother, it's embarrassing. We shouldn't mention Sandy's name in front of Angel.
Meningning, it's okay. Oh, Virgie, I'm really sorry that we just met. Well, it's all Habagat's fault. I've been asking him for some time now to introduce me to you already. It's only now that he's agreed to do it for me.
Well, that's okay. Oh, by the way, how did my brother manage to fool you?
Meningning, please.
Oh, come on, Meningning. I was the one who wooed your brother. It took me some time before I finally fooled him and got him to say yes.
What? Shouldn't the man do the courting? Is that what your parents have been teaching you?
Mother, Angel, go on. Habagat, go on. Why don't you step out for now?
Let's go.
Mother, come on. Aren't you happy for him? It's a good thing Habagat has that Angel now because it's better than having him mope around inside the house.
Something doesn't feel right about that girl. Did you see how she was dressed?
Mother, come on. You shouldn't be doubting her. You just met her. Give her a chance. Take some time to get to know Angel better.
So, Sandy, Armin, I've already scheduled your wedding. So why do you want to move your schedule earlier?
It's because I might change my mind about it. I was just kidding, Father Simon. Oh, well, the truth about it is, because my sister found out about my wedding, and I just don't want her to show up uninvited.
Haven't you and your sister reconciled yet?
No, not yet. And it's unlikely that will ever happen. I'm sorry I didn't tell you I wanted to get married earlier.
Don't worry about it.
Sandy, you know that getting married is the beginning of your new life. Shouldn't this include forgiving your sister for whatever wrongdoing she may have done to you? Whatever problems may have been.
Well, if that's what it will take for Armand and I to get married, then okay, I'll forgive my sister.
You know, it's not easy to forgive.
Well, you said it yourself, Father. I know it's not that easy to forgive someone. And I've been trying to avoid getting my sister involved in my wedding with Armand. So there, if you won't marry us just because of my sister, Elena, then we can just get married in some other place.
No, don't say things like that, Sandy. It's embarrassing.
I've made up my mind, Armand. That's why I'm asking, Father. I need you to please marry me and Armand in the soonest possible time.
Hello, Madam Rosa.
What have you been doing all this time? I'm bored out of my mind in this hideout. Tell me, when will you finally end Manining's life?
It'll be soon, Madam Rosa.
Well, it should be. I want Manining dead by tomorrow.
If not,
you are the one who is going to be dead. You understand, or don't you?
I understand you clearly, Madam Rosa.
I already have a plan on how I'll go about killing Manining.
And how many times do I have to tell you, Harry? It's dangerous for you to keep coming to our house.
Why is that? Are you scared of your father now? I thought no one scares you. Why do you look like you're about to pee yourself?
I'm not scared at all, Harry. I'm just careful. Because the last time you went here, my father saw us talking to each other.
Harry, are you even thinking of using my own daughter against me?
Hey.
Yes?
Should we tell Manining already?
Tell her what?
About what Sir Harry told us, the story he told us, remember? I'm having a very hard time. I can't even look at her straight in the eye when I'm talking to her.
What's wrong with you? Just can't. Virgil already warned us never to tell Manining anything that Sir Harry told us.
Your boss is really a scoundrel. He's just evil. Imagine raping Virgil like that.
But there's an even bigger question. Why is Virgil covering for him? Why was she raped?
I don't know, but you know what? I really don't like talking about it much. It really looks like we're gossiping. But what's more important is that we have to let Manining know. I just can't keep a secret from her.
Hey. Tell me what. Well, what do you guys have to tell me? What? What do you need to let me know?
Hey, you do it.
No, Maningning, we were just talking about those three rape victims over the next town, that's all.
Oh, yes.
No one's really safe anymore.
Oh, yes, yes.
Old or young
or gay.
Yes.
Well, everyone's fair game.
So that's why we were discussing who'd watch over you. It's better to be more careful.
Yes, right.
Mm-hmm. You're right. The women living around our place should be more careful.
Yes.
But I'm fine. You don't have to guard me at all. Besides, I'm sure that Armin is doing something to solve that.
Whoa.
Yes, right?
Yes, yes, maybe. Yes.
I think you two should be careful, too.
You're so loud.
Well, you always just blame me anyway. Just follow my lead, okay?
Just
trust me. Just follow my lead. You're crazy.
You're so loud.
Maningning.
Yes.
So why should I be more careful? Why should we be more careful?
That's because you two are usually out on the streets very late at night. You guys might be mistaken for those two famous rapists.
Me? Me?
Me?
Be mistaken for a rapist? Maybe him.
Me?
It's the way he looks. His hair alone makes him look like a maniac.
No, no. You always pick on me. But then, Maningning, if ever you hear about a man who was raped, then you'll know who. Him. The culprit.
You're crazy.
You two are just impossible. See? You know, you two just have nothing better to do. Well, okay, you guys just help me sell this. Him. You messed up all my fish.
Okay, wait a second. I'll just put that back. I'll just fix it. I'll help you out. Just let me hit this guy.
Hey!
And
hey,
you!
Hey, stop!
Hey, will you stop that? My fish are getting stale. Well, stop
hey,
it.
Hey, it's like you didn't hear what Maningning said, huh?
Come on.
Oh, you're crazy.
Come
on.
Hey, not that!
Oh, so that's it.
Oh, no, you!
Come on, Eric.
You joined them! What's wrong with my boyfriend? You're very childish. You're still childish! Hey! I said stop it!
Could you really blame me for stacking all of the cards in my favor before I start going against you with my life? The thing is, your daughter is very tough. She just won't give in. It's all right. If you ever change your mind, just send word for me in the province, okay? Did he hurt you, Cassandra?
No, Harry didn't do anything to me.
Well, if that's the case, then good. Go on, then.
Plan. Wretched plan. Your plan better be good. So what is this plan of yours, my dear gunman?
If I can't kill her tonight, then I'll finish Maningning off in the morning.
Well, then that's why you have done it. Your plan is a big joke. Is something wrong with your head? Are you crazy?
Well, isn't that the reason why you hired me for your services, Madam Rosa?
Because I'm crazy enough?
I'll do it at the port.
Right in the middle of the fish port. I'll execute my plan there. In finishing off Maningning.
Well, you better be quick, like the quick brown fox that jumps over the lazy dog.
I want to go home to that country.
And I just want to see my sons again.
Hey, hey, watch hey, it. Just stop on, it.
What's wrong with you?
I said that's enough.
Okay, then, okay.
I don't know. Why really? Why don't I let you get me into this?
Come on, move on.
There.
Because you love him.
Grandmother.
My grandchild.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You'll start smelling like fish.
Come on.
That's okay. It's so much fun to watch you and your friends here. I can remember when you were still young, and I used to buy fish from you. Well, they've always been that lively. Oh, Maningning. I visited you here because I would like to ask you for a favor.
What is it?
Well, I went to see Eleanor, and she's looking for you. She said that she wants to talk to you.
What? But why me? What does she want to talk to me about?
I don't know. She didn't mention anything, but she...
She just kept repeating that she wanted to talk to you.
Well, sir, I just wanted to ask for your advice. It's about this girl I'm courting. It's just that I heard you have this way and style with the women.
When I was younger, yes. But now that I'm a lot older, I've laid low on that already. What kind of girl are you trying to impress, Bukol?
Well, sir, she's kind of, she's very tough and comes off a little snobbish. She's like, Maningning's mom, Virgie. Sir, I just wanted to know how you got Virgie to say yes to you. It might give me a clue on how I can finally make this girl give me the time of day.
Bukol, you know I've never really courted Virgie.
Sir. So, could you tell me how Maningning and Mayumi turned out to be your kids? Sir, it's just that I heard about this news. It was Harry who told me that you raped Virgie and that was how you got her pregnant with your twins.
Well, that's good. You collected the payment. Just keep up the good work, Sandy. That way I won't have any trouble tallying these. Oh, and San... So what? It just hurts you when you see them together, right?
What are you talking about, Cheetah?
Hush! Stop pretending. It's so obvious from the look in your eyes, your actions. Admit it already, Sandy. Do you still love Habagat?
Well, just look at him. He loves someone else now.
Well, that's just it. The only solution to that, Sandy, is to getting married to Armand as soon as possible. So, when you're finally married, that will put an end to your illusions about Habagat. So there, he's right on time. Oh, you just have a perfect timing, Daddy Armand. You should just get married so that this will finally end this tragic soap opera of yours.
What soap opera is he talking about?
Nothing. You know exactly what a gossip cheetah is. So what now? Have you eaten yet?
Not yet. Do you want to go eat?
Let's go.
So have you told Maningning about Harry's little story?
No, I haven't, sir, but Virgie knows about it, and that's what she told me to do. She did not want me to tell Maningning either. But, sir, is that all true? sir!
If Virgie forbade you from telling Maningning, then I'm ordering you to do the same. And don't you ever let this reach Maningning. And the next time you meddle into my affairs, I'll forget that you're my favorite. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Well, in that case, very good. Okay, then. Now go and make sure the shipment's in order.